I'm going to show you guys how to set up this AI voice changer. It's free and it's probably the best solution right now you can use for AI voice changers. So what you're going to do is go to the link in the description, the GitHub. You're going to scroll down. Pro tip, if you ever come across this and it's not translating, you can select translate selection up here, translate full page. And we're going to go down to right here where it's got these downloads. So you want the most recent one, but this right here is going to be if you have AMD, or sorry, the direct ML one right here is if you have AMD. And this one here is going to be if you have NVIDIA. So I'm going to click this one because I have NVIDIA. It's going to pull up this. And what you're going to do is just go to the one on the bottom and make sure that if you have NVIDIA, it's GPU CUDA. If you have AMD, it's going to be this one, direct ML CUDA. It is 3.2 gigs, but go ahead and download it. I've already downloaded it, obviously, but once you have it, you're going to unzip it to a folder on your desktop. So I'm here in that folder now. And what you're going to do is scroll down to, you're going to find HTTP start, or it's start underscore HTTP dot bat. So what you're going to do is actually, first of all, make a shortcut or go to show more options, create shortcut. It'll be at the bottom, or you can sort by date modified, that makes it easy. And it'll be at the top. Then you can drop that on your desktop. That'll just make things a whole lot easier and faster. So you're gonna start that. It's gonna take a minute. It's gonna download some dependencies and stuff. Mine's already done, so it'll go a little bit faster than yours. Just give it a while. And so once you have this client open, you are almost done. So as you can see, you're only going to have a few models. The models that come with it are not really usable for English because they're designed for Japanese. So in the link in the description, I have this page here by the Shinonome AI Lab RVC branch. They have released 3,182 models, and these are actually good models too. So that's a place I would recommend to find them. I have a few here already. So what you're actually going to do for the setup here, scroll down and you want to change audio to server, and on input you're going to find your microphone. Now I have it set to MME, my microphone. I'm not really sure the difference. I just know that this one works good, so that's what I would use on the output. We're going to get into this in a second. So you're going to actually set up Voicemeter, which will allow you to route it. So I'll get to that in a second, but for chunk size, I have a 4060 Ti and I'm able to use a 192, which is a half a second delay. And then I put the extra at 65,000. That helps to smooth it out and it doesn't sound so choppy. And I'll show you an example of it here at the end, but let's finish the setup here. So you're also going to need this right here, Voicemeter. You go ahead and download that. I already have it done, obviously. So once you are here, what you're going to do is you have to just set an output. So I have it set to an output that I don't use, and then I have it turned down all the way. I'm not really sure on this, honestly. I just know that I tried around, tried some things, and this is what worked. So that's what I did. This is just a monitor, so that way you won't hear yourself. You turn this all the way down. But you're going to pick something that you don't really use. So I have it set to this auxiliary steel series sonar. So you're done with that now. That's all you needed to do there. You're going to come here, go to output, and you're going to select MME voice meter input. You can turn on the monitor. That way you can hear the voice whenever you talk, and you can test it out on here. So I just have it set to SteelSeries Sonar Media. It could be whatever. It could be your speakers, your headset, whatever. So let me see here. I'm going to turn my mic off and I'm going to show you what this is going to sound like, okay? You just click start.
You just click. All right, here we go. This is Arthur Morgan from Red Dead Redemption. And it's pretty darn good, let me tell you.
All right, so that's what it's going to sound like. And, you might have to play around with these settings a bit, but make sure your GPU is selected because the CPU does not work very good. These are just what worked for me. If you have a stronger GPU, you could probably get this lower if you wanted. But another thing to mention is that when you first get the models, if you download them, you're going to click edit. You're going to go down here. You're going to click upload. For the model, you're going to find the model.pth right there. And then for the index, you're going to go to the .index right there. So you have to download both of these whenever you are getting a new model. I'll show you in the files. You've got model.pth, you've got model.index. Those are the only two things you need. Once you have those, what you're going to do to get some better performance is you're going to, let me find one that's not done. Here's GLaDOS. So whenever it's not in Onyx, it'll say export to Onyx. So you're going to do that and save the file into a folder. And then you're going to click edit, come down here, and then you're going to add the Onyx one. So as you see, I have a folder with all of them that are all converted already. And it kind of saves file size. It's, I would just recommend, I think they sound better whenever you do this. So once you have it and it's on the Onyx version, or it'll say underscore simple, you go here and you're going to select RMVPE Onyx. And that's it. If you need to record a clip, you can do that here. Otherwise, it's going to be live. That's pretty much everything. If you guys have any questions whatsoever, just leave a comment and I will help you guys out the best I can.